welcome back to the Red Crew. It's your boy Chesco. I'm here with David. I'm here with Luis. We're here with another week of the Red Crew. We did a great week for us, right?
It was amazing.
Amazing week. We got a lot of new subscribers.
A lot of sacrifices, though.
Nice. We're close to 400.
10 away.
10 away from 400.
Oh, shit.
So, just keep it going. Keep it moving.
Yes.
We'll get there. We'll get there. How was your week?
Uneventful. Gladly.
As always, glad that you're consistent.
Yeah,
thanks. Keep it. About right.
How about you, David? You weren't in town, right? Where'd you go?
I went to a wedding. Very, very beautiful wedding.
Did you want it to go?
Yeah, actually. Yeah. Okay. It was nice. It was a nice one.
Was it from your side or her side?
Man, that's kind of a tricky question because I've known them longer, but she's closer to them.
Oh, okay.
So, I mean, it was kind of...
Girls always doing that.
She's stealing my friends.
How dare they build
keep your friends, please. Like, do I go and take your whack-ass friends?
Yeah, exactly, dude. I got the cooler friends.
But I think it's because...
Well, Luis does. Luis does.
Like, he does that shit.
Sure do.
He does that, yeah. Like, he's like, I'm like, who's your close friend? And he's like, some dude. I don't even remember his name. I'm like, how you met him? He's like... He is the husband of one of my girls.
Oh, my God.
That's not your friend, bro. The minute y'all break up, guess what? He gone.
Yeah. Sadly, it's a relationship acquaintance, that's bro.
And I've learned it because that same thing happened with my last relationship.
Yeah, I'm telling you. It's like, you gotta keep your own friends. Only us, man. Don't talk to nobody else. Don't talk to nobody else. Like,
not allowed to.
When anymore. Your girl's gone.
Not allowed to. I don't let my girl tell me what I'm not allowed. I am or I'm not allowed to.
I'm telling you. Because when you break up with your girl, we still going to be here.
More like when she breaks up with me.
Some dude gave him a glove.
What?
Right?
A glove. Yeah. Ted.
Where did you meet him?
Like a Michael Jackson glove? What kind of glove is it?
It's a pool glove.
Oh, it's an OJ glove.
Yeah. Pool glove. Nice.
Yeah.
I broke my hand. You should see the other guy.
Tell us about it.
He's fine. he's fine. Hey, no, but I went to the emergency room. I'm not gonna lie, we could do a podcast there. Honestly, it's a little frustrating because
it is a little less loud.
Thank you. It's a little frustrating because there's some people that are in front of me. Let's be honest, you got here a little too late, bro. You're gonna die. Like,
instead of going first, you should just be last.
Yeah, I'm like, you know what? Just like, let's put you to the back of the line. If we're able to get to you and you're still alive, let's just call it a bonus. But like, I still have a lot to live for. So you should let me go first.
I mean,
and
nothing really happened to you. You just kind of broke one small bone in your hand.
On this
cast, second metacarpal.
Then a hand. Then?
Yeah, the whole hand right here. I need a surgery next week.
Jesus.
And then I get into an argument with my doctor. A little bit of an asshole doctor, I'm not gonna lie.
Who don't you get an argument with?
I know.
No, because he's like, you need surgery. I'm like, okay, let's start this. Like, let's start over. Like, okay, most people need surgery, but it's on my record. I'm a thug.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm
not most people, okay?
Yeah, look at my history. Exactly, I'm a thug, dude. Does that apply to
don't
me?
Don't you watch the record?
Look,
did
it should
you
be.
Didn't you read it?
It no, should be on not. My doctor record yeah, right there. I'm exactly. a thug. And he's like, no, you still need surgery. And I'm like, then they sent me to another doctor, so I'm going to have that argument with him next week.
You got an argument.
I got an argument scheduled with him. Like, hey, bro, I think there's a mistake here. Like, why do I need surgery? Bro. Like,
I've been told multiple times I need surgery, but. I just don't get it. Yeah.
Like I'm
basically fucking Wolverine over here, dude. That shit just gets better.
I was told I need surgery in my Achilles. Until that bitch pop, I ain't getting
nothing. Oh. Like, that one hurt.
Yeah, I heard that's one of like, the most painful things.
Yeah.
I don't think so. Cause you never tore it. But were you there when I tore my ACL? I think you were.
No, I don't think so. There? I don't think so.
Okay, so it was playing with the team he took me to. Maybe he just wasn't there. But, it hurts so bad for like 5 minutes. Like terrible. I've never felt pain like that. After that, it went away. And I was like, oh, let me try to play again. But
the thug kicked in, right?
Yeah.
The thug kicked in.
Maybe that's
what it is, bro.
You don't have a good leg kick, so yeah, the thug kicked in.
The thug kicked in.
Gotcha.
I tried to play again, but I couldn't. Every time I ran, like my knee will give out. But yesterday, it was crazy because I was playing again. First play of the game. I broke my hand. So I had to play the whole game with a broken hand.
With a broken hand, dude.
Yeah, and so, but like I said, I'm a thug. Louis is a little punk when it comes to this stuff, huh?
Why do you say that?
Because every time we say something, you're like, oh.
Look, it's funny because I told you about my foot, right?
Yeah.
I dislocated and I broke it and it was dangling up on the side. When it happened to me, it's like I have a picture of me holding my leg and it dangling on the side. I'm not smiling.
Nice.
And I'm smiling and everything's fine. And all I'm thinking about is I hope that the adrenaline doesn't kick in before I get to the hospital.
But or whatever doesn't go I see, away, right?
It doesn't go away.
Yeah.
Sorry, yeah, it doesn't go away.
Yeah.
But whenever I see other people like going through, because that happened on me. If it happened on me, I can see it on other people. I see it on other people. I'm a little baby when it comes to that stuff.
So. Okay. The visual of it.
Yeah.
You remember that you had to go to the hospital? You probably don't remember.
I remember.
You remember?
Yeah.
You had to go to the hospital in the game. He got kicked in the head.
Oh, I'm thinking another game, dude. Remember when I broke my arm? We were, dude, it was fucked up, dude. The game got...
Oh, you fell, huh?
No. The game was forfeited. We didn't play.
Oh, on the way. You got hit by a car.
It was on the way out. Yeah.
And not a player, a car.
Yeah, a fucking car.
I thought
car
he was talking hit. On the field. Yeah, I was there. I was behind him, yeah.
Yeah.
He got hit by a car.
It's fucking funny, dude. I was reaching for a piece of candy. I swear to God.
No,
I was reaching for a piece of candy.
Do you remember that in the game you got kicked in the head?
Yeah.
I don't remember. Yeah, I don't know when you came to, but he got.
Dude, I played the whole game.
He played the whole game, and then.
I did all right, dude.
Yeah, he did good. I was like, David's doing good.
He played better when he got hit in the head.
Yeah, when he's not playing that great, I'm like, hey, just hit him.
He won't even remember it.
We didn't. During the game, we didn't know everything was wrong with him. Because he played fine. He played normal. He played the entire game. Then.
Insane, dude.
After the game, he just started asking the same question over and over and over again.
I thought it was just the guy who took me home.
No, we got it and everything. Shit. And then we had a group text. And he's like, what do we do with him?
Dude, the dumbass that took me home was he's pothead. I just smoked this, dude. All right, smoke this,
like the one thing you're not supposed to do is fall asleep.
Oh, well, I guess that shit kept me up, dude.
Or I don't know. I don't even know if I smoked.
When did you come back? Like in the car?
When I got home, I remember getting home. Like my dad was like opening the door. He's like, What happened? That's what I remember.
Oh, that was a long time.
Yeah. But like the game, I don't remember. The drive home, I don't remember. That's when I came to when I got to my parents' house, actually.
Damn, that's crazy.
That's crazy, yeah.
Yeah,
like straight up concussion. Good now, you know what I'm saying?
No, in the emergency room, yeah, I was getting a little frustrated. There's a guy in front of me, like with a barf bag. They give you a barf bag, and he's just like, "Oh, I'm like, shut up, dude."
Yeah.
Do you have a broken hand?
do you know what he had?
Yeah, pussyitis. What else could it be? Babyitis he had. Yeah.
How you would be as a doctor?
I would be a thug. I'm not gonna lie. There's some people like, hey, bro, if we gotta like, if you're gonna live, we're gonna need a little effort here. like, I'm just supposed to save you on my own.
Like, you gotta work for it, you know.
You gotta work for it. I'm telling you. I think I would have been a good doctor. Like, how they say it takes like 8 years to become a doctor, huh?
They say.
I'm like, I think there's a lot of lazy people. I'm like, if you put some effort, we could do it about 3.5.
Yeah.
Like, there's no need to go to school for 8 years.
But part of that is interning. Like, part of the 8 years is interning as a
RN like or a residency or whatnot.
Yeah, exactly, the residency.
Even that, you know, like, goddamn.
Like, no, because my cousin's a doctor, and he's going for like plastic surgery, but he's not even a surgeon.
Okay.
And. He's been at it for a while. I'm like, come on, bro.
Did he watch Grey's Anatomy?
No, that's part of the problem.
Well, that's what it is.
That's part of the problem.
Been, at least 7 years.
That is absolutely part of the problem.
If he would have grown up watching Grey's Anatomy in 7 years, at least 7 years, he would have done it.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie. I pay a lot of money for my lawyer. I have a good lawyer. Now, I started watching Suits.
Oh, what's a good show.
I started watching Suits.
You got it.
Trust me, I'm deleting the number. I'm deleting the number. I don't need it no more, bro.
About to call Harvey?
Yeah, I'm like, I don't need it no more. I'm like, I took Well, what was his name? Well, Mike.
I got five seasons. I'm gonna do that. Yeah. I think that should be a requirement, though. If you're gonna be a doctor, one semester, watch Grey's Anatomy.
Absolutely.
If you're gonna be a lawyer, suits.
Before you take the bar, watch Suits.
You gonna be a cop?
Get your shit straight.
Cops and NCIS.
NCIS, bro.
Is NCIS a cop show?
It's an NCIS show.
Investigation,
what are they called?
Show, right? There's, if you want to be a private,
there's special agents. Special agents. Yeah. Or Law and Order.
Law and Order.
Watch Law and Order.
That's semester two for the lawyers.
Yeah, watch Law and Order. Like, that's, TV could teach you a lot.
Yeah.
TV could teach you a lot. If I was a lawyer, the other lawyer wouldn't be able to talk. I'd be like, I object.
To what? Doesn't matter. Stop talking.
Like, hey, my name is Luis. I object. Like, I'll be objecting every, like, man. Oh man, now I really wish I was a lawyer. He's like, my name is Luis. I object. Like, that's the truth. You can't handle the truth.
I wish I was a lawyer, but that's not too much. There's no way they're gonna take my case over there.
Man, nah. What other shows y'all watch that could help you in life?
Let's see, dude.
I don't watch that many shows.
Breaking Bad, if you're on the opposite side of the law, right? You know, that's a good one.
Better Call Saul.
Better Call Saul. Better another Call lawyer Saul. Show. Yeah.
What is that?
Semester three.
It's, yeah, you never watched Breaking Bad?
No, I haven't.
It's, he's it's a lawyer.
Spin-off. Yeah,
for,
it's a spinoff.
Yeah, for Walter White.
For everybody, really.
Who's Walter White?
Yeah. Walter White is the main protagonist of the movie, of the show.
The show. He's that's a good show, man. You should watch that after you finish Suits.
I'm almost done.
And then do Better Call Saul. No, it's the other show, the about the barbarians.
The one. Oh, I think I know it, but no,
Game of Thrones.
Game of Thrones.
Holy shit!
No, I'll never.
I mean, that one's pretty good.
Too. I only watch things that can help me in life. If I ever run into a dragon, I'm fucked. But like, I don't.
Unless you watch Game of Thrones.
But I'm gonna take my chances. Like, you know, I can. But I'm not gonna lie. Next week's episode is gonna come out a little late for two reasons. Broke my hand, and I've been watching Suits, doing nothing but watching Suits. So it's like, it's when I get into a show, I get into it. Like, I don't really watch.
You
a
gotta
lot
binge them, you know.
Yeah,
you might as well. Yeah, yeah,
Suits is done, right?
Yeah.
I'm in season five.
Oh, you got like four more seasons.
I got four more seasons. I can finish them bitches by tomorrow. Like,
what's the other one? Oh no, it's like Mad Men, right? It's not about lawyers.
I've never seen Mad Men. That's about marketing, though.
Marketing, right? Yeah.
She's really good.
I guess
the one that I've never watched and I've always like, I want to watch it, is Entourage.
Okay. Entourage.
I've never.
Oh, yeah. I've never seen it. A lot of people like it, though.
So and Sopranos is supposed to be good, too.
What is it?
I've watched Sopranos.
Sopranos. Ooh, Sopranos. Ooh, no.
Do you like it?
My best friend likes
it. I like it. I like it.
You recommend it?
Again, but you got to be a little bit of a thug to watch it. Because it's about. So I feel identified.
Okay.
Monsters, right?
I feel identified.
Relate.
I can relate. Gotcha, yeah. Gotcha. Can relate. Let me ask you a question. Y'all seen this video? A guy by himself in the VIP.
He got a bottle.
He got a section. He got bottles, everything by himself. Like, you said that you're somebody not to do, you didn't used to do this, but you said you used to go places by yourself, like to watch the UFC fights and things like this.
Yeah.
Would you, could you be able to do this?
No, not like that.
No?
I feel like that's too much attention. I go places by myself to be by myself. Like, at that point, you're getting all the attention to yourself. Yeah. I don't want the attention.
But if you go to Buffalo Wild Wings to watch UFC fights, like, there's a lot of people around you.
Yeah, but they're watching the fight. They're not watching me.
Oh, are there a lot of people there by themselves, though?
Yeah, actually, I'm at the bar.
At the bar. Oh, okay.
Because
I'm not going to lie. And I've gotten better at this. Like, a lot of times, I love Perry Perry. So a lot of times I'm here and like say it happens all the time that I'm gonna meet somebody or something like that and they're like, hey, I'll make it. I'm backed up, so I'm 30 minutes off or 45 or an hour or whatever. Then I'll just go to Perry Perry and eat. But I used to be a person I couldn't go anywhere by myself.
It's tough, I think.
Yeah,
it's tough,
I used to be like that. Awkward.
It's awkward. Yeah.
You know
yeah,
what
yeah,
the weirdest thing is? Going to movies by yourself.
I've never done that in my
I've
life.
I've seen people do that shit. Yeah.
You've done that? What movie did you watch?
I don't even remember. I just remember I just want to be out of the house.
Was this when you were married?
This is when I was through the end of my marriage, yeah.
Makes sense.
End of my marriage and beginning of, like, the divorce separation.
That happened to me in the pandemic. Like, I'm not going to lie to you. The pandemic hit me hard for like 2 days. It was like...
It was 2 years, bro.
Huh? Shit. You thought it was going to be years? No. Yeah. It was like 2 days. Oh, I don't know if you remember. Oh, because you came and watched one of them with us, I think, at Edgar's house.
Maybe.
Yeah, like the Masvidal one, I think. Okay. But before that, we watched like the first one. And I remember talking to him. And you know how E.T. is. He's like, fuck that. I don't believe in this. I don't believe. In the beginning, he was believing.
No way.
In the beginning, he was like legit. Like, he wasn't going anywhere. Nobody was going anywhere. And I was like, and we started texting each other. I was like, bro, for real? Like, now it's starting to get to me a little bit. Like, there is nothing to do. Yeah, I remember I watched like every single season of The Ultimate Fighter.
Jesus, like, Christ.
Dang. Oh, yeah, you did say that.
I watched like every single season. Me and my girl would go to Cane's and eat in the car.
Yeah, there's a lot of car dates. Or
yeah,
car
like, shit, yeah. You know? Yeah. We'll eat in the car and
fucking just sit there.
And just sit there.
That's all you can do.
That's when we started the podcast.
Oh, really?
The idea of the podcast. Shit. Like,
oh, because of the...
We didn't have this room, so we need a room for the podcast. So we started like, we got to do something. We're not just gonna.
Yeah. And
it was crazy, and then everybody, which now that I think about it, it was counterintuitive for me because. A lot of our clients started getting money, and then now I realize how they got it. They're all in jail. But like
PPP loans.
They didn't have Harvey.
No, they didn't have Harvey, but they did have PPP loans.
But jail.
Did you have a whole bunch of people come in and tell you, hey, go get a loan?
Yeah, they were like, it's easy,
I was the one
bro.
Telling them. Yeah, because I worked at a bank, so I was the one telling them, don't get a loan.
Oh,
yeah.
Hey, so how did that work? Like, people couldn't come to your bank. What would you do?
No, we had the drive-through open.
Yes.
So people could still deposit and withdraw.
Oh, you were a teller.
Yeah. No, I was a banker, but that I did nothing, and I got paid for it for a good 3 months.
Nice.
Until they gave us something to do, which was just call.
Tell me about it. I did nothing for 3 months.
Yeah.
It was crazy. Like,
sat around and got fat, dude.
Well, you know what? I got paid every single
day. Yeah, that's the best part.
It was. There was nothing that it was like. They used to make us get on meetings, like Zoom meetings, like once a week to like to nothing.
Hey, what are you doing? Nothing. What are you doing? Nothing.
No. Okay. So I can't say what I. But let's just say clients, right? Yeah. Our membership. We used to call our membership. And we would be like, for example, if it was David, like, hey, David, how's it going? And I remember they told us, we were instructed, like, if you ever need anything, if anybody gets sick, like, let us know. And my thinking, for what?
Like, that's good to know. Thank you for letting us know.
Like, for what? Like, say David calls me. And then I'm like, damn, man. Good luck.
Damn, dog.
That is a conundrum. Yeah. Conundrum.
Yeah, man. Good luck. Try not to cough on anybody.
Hey, best thing I could do is say watch Grey's Anatomy. The fuck. Best I could do, buddy.
I didn't tell my. I wasn't gonna go against my boss at anything because he was paying me, right? But I was like, why? Why would they call me?
Did he ever like explain like with the?
No, I wasn't gonna ask a question, bro. I'm telling you, no. Like, if this is all you want me to do so I can keep paying, yeah, I'll tell him. Yeah. Hey, if you get COVID, call me. Like, that's the way to go.
I watch Grey's Anatomy.
Yeah.
The only thing I can send you is a link to my Netflix. The best I can give you. I don't know what else to do for you. No, it was not. The thing that hurt me the most, like, for like 2 days, I'm not going to lie to you, 2 days. It was, okay, first, like I said, sports went away.
Oh, that one sucked.
And if you know me, that's like my that's like my
sanctuary,
like my safe space. And sports completely went away. Then what you call it? Remember, I don't know if y'all remember, Dana White comes out and says that Tony Ferguson versus Khabib is not canceled.
Gosh.
Cause that was the next pay-per-view.
Heard
He's
of that.
Like, no, it's not canceled. And then he was like, we're going to do it in, what is it called, where the natives are?
The natives?
The natives?
Oh,
like,
The what? The natives?
Indian territory?
Yeah, a territory.
Oh, okay, yeah.
They have their own territory.
The reservations, yeah.
Native American territory?
Native American territory where, I don't know, the government doesn't govern there, right?
Yeah, yeah.
They have special rights.
They have their...
Yeah, they govern themselves.
And then... Wow. I was like, yeah, that's Dana White. I'm down. I'm in. And like, so I can survive to that UFC.
Yeah.
And then that got canceled.
Damn.
When that got canceled, I'm not going to lie. It's like,
it got real.
It got real for me. I'm like, damn. And then I remember a whole bunch of celebrities like, stay home, stay home, stay home. Bitch, yeah, you're fine in your home. Come stay in my home.
Yeah, for real.
They said, would you stay in my home? Like that,
barely got a couch.
Yeah, I'm like... And then like, stay with your loved ones. I'm like, I already saw her enough. Like, see other people. Like, and nah, yeah, it got real for like, and for those few days, I was like, damn, man, what the hell is gonna happen? I was really like, and then he announced, when the Gaethje Ferguson fight was gonna happen, I was like, all right, I can survive till then. And I remember that's when me and E.T. started talking. And we were like, damn, that's going to be crazy. So we're going to, you down to meet up for that one. And like, and we were like, should we not? And he was like, nah, it's cool. It'll be just us and we'll get food and things like that. And like, all right. So we met up for that one. But the night before, one of the fighters caught COVID.
Oh shit!
And I was like, "If this thing gets canceled, I'm gonna cry." Like, I'm not lying, man. I was like terrified, and it didn't get canceled, and then it just started like slowly coming back. Yeah, so I was like, yeah. I was cool. Yeah. But I remember like the first week of COVID, I went out. I went to the gym. It was like The Walking Dead.
In the street.
It was empty, huh?
It was empty.
Yeah, there was no traffic.
No traffic. That was actually the best part.
That was the best part.
Yeah, no traffic anywhere. And no matter what time of the day.
Yeah.
You were working where you're working now?
Yeah, I was the last one to get fucking laid off or furloughed or whatever the fuck.
No.
I was working at a hotel. And yeah, I was like, well, fuck.
They let you go?
Huh?
They let you go?
No, it was the last one. Like, they didn't fire anyone per se. It was at like that furlough shit.
Well, that means they just send you home.
Yeah, you send you home with pay or whatever. But I was the last one to get fucking furloughed, so I was like, "Hey, send me home already, fuckers! I want to get paid for sitting on my ass."
Like I said, I'm the biggest Suits fan now. Okay, so y'all know who Meghan Markle is?
Yes.
Right?
Yeah, of course.
She was in Suits. She's the Queen of England now, right? Am I correct?
Not even close.
Okay.
Not even
close. What is she?
Absolutely nothing. They seceded from the dynasty.
Yeah, they got out, dude.
And good job, Meghan. Now, she was the Queen of England for like 2 weeks.
Not even.
Well, I'm a roll with that. So now it's like, from what I see, she was the Queen of England.
She was a duchess.
Okay, same thing. Same
Duchess
thing.
Is Sussex or some shit, right?
Something like that.
What do you think is cooler? To be the King of England? Hey, if I marry the Queen of England, does that make me the King of England? I don't understand why not.
Maybe.
You have to be born to the dynasty.
You think he's right? I don't think he's
right. I don't know. That sounds like incest to me, dude. I don't know. I think there is a lot of incest going on over there, though.
So I'm like, okay, so... If my girl marries me, she can take half my stuff. But if I marry her, I can't become the King of England? Or Puerto Rico?
That's what happened to...
Puerto Rico, yeah.
That's what happened to Princess Diana.
What happened to her?
She separated from I think... I forgot what
the... From life, bro. They killed her. What do you mean? The fuck?
You're not wrong.
They fucking killed her. She separated.
Why do people say they killed her?
Because they didn't like her, dude.
They didn't want her to be out there spreading a lot of the things that she was talking about.
Yeah, much, she was, according to them, kind of like a loudmouth.
I thought she was cheating on her husband.
Nah.
Well, the part of it was, from what I understand, is that they didn't... The kingdom doesn't recognize divorce. Because the kingdom is under the power of the power of the church. So they do not recognize divorce. So they didn't want her to get divorced, but eventually the queen was like, I will allow it, right? I will allow it. But during that middle ground, I think there was some overlapping of partnerships.
Mm.
Oh.
Crazy.
Anyways, Meghan Markle. Like, what's cooler?
The new Diana.
To be the Queen of England? Or to be an actress?
She obviously thinks actress.
Well, she stopped acting, huh?
No, she. I think. I guess at that point,
they make documentaries and shit now, and they're part of
the documentaries about your own life. You're not an actor.
Yeah, I guess that's true. But you I don't know. They're still in Hollywood. You could say
trying to expose the whole dynasty.
Nah, I don't think so. I think it was more like.
No, because they.
Why did they succeed?
I think Harry is his name. From what I understand, Harry was supporting of her, and there was a lot of racism within the
kingdom. Yeah, I think that's what
it was. So she's like, I don't want to be a part of this. So
Harry or her?
No, she said that, and he was supporting of that.
Yeah.
So they both relinquished their royal duties.
What was her duty?
I don't know.
I'm wondering how they met, right? Like,
I don't know if they met in England.
I don't know the story about how they met.
I think I can make it up pretty well. Like,
I want you.
Nah, they met. They probably met at a party, like in Vegas or in LA.
Yeah, probably.
Like, what does the Prince of England have to do? If the King of England has nothing to do, what do you think the Prince of England has to do? Because it's not like they that makes no sense to me. Like, I understand if you're the King of England. If you were like the only power there, but there is a prime minister.
I don't get that. I don't understand. I don't even think this was like a separation of powers. I just think the prime minister or the actual, I don't know what you would call it, parliament is what rules England. I don't know what powers the
kingdoms have. Kingdom nothing. Has, yeah? They're just there to take tax money from the people.
I think so. No, I really do think that's part of it.
There's nothing else. Like, it's crazy.
And at least the kings of Dubai, they do stuff for the country, you know?
Yeah, they run the country.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, and they're called the... What are they called?
The kings of Dubai? The sheiks?
Sheiks, there you go. Sheiks, yeah. Yeah, like, that makes sense to me because there's no other power. It's them. But it's like, you're not... Yeah, you don't run anything. You're just born into it. Mm-hmm. And then I actually do something... I trick one of your queens to marry me, and I don't get the power. That's just unfair. Bullshit, bro. That's all I wanted to say. Meghan Markle, thank God for leaving, and she's fine.
That's part of the reason why they stopped the show.
Cause she's fine.
Cause she stopped. She stopped acting on the show.
No, they stopped it like 3 years later.
I think popularity fell down because
No, she wasn't the main character.
They got rid of Mike too.
Well,
you don't know this yet, but they got rid of
Mike. No, I did know this.
Okay.
But again, but let's just say this. I don't know if you knew this. Her and Mike aren't the same person. They're not the same person. So just because she left doesn't mean he has to leave.
No, but the way they wrote it out was that they went to.
Yeah, I got it. I got that. Now, what I'm saying. He's gonna hit you back. Watch out. Don't touch Jorge like that. He'll hit you back.
But like you were saying.
Like, so yeah, they're not the same people. Just because she left doesn't mean the show ended.
I think they ended up bringing him back for like a couple episodes. But I know, I agree.
For years. Literally years.
It was like one season.
No, it was not one season.
Watch it. You're on season 4.
No, but I do my due diligence.
Okay, what do you know that I don't know?
It went 9 seasons.
Okay.
She left in season 6. Is it me or is it not one season? Like, 9 minus 6 is? He said? Who's right and who's wrong?
Yeah, he said off for one season and then they wrote him off.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about Mike.
Oh, no, I'm not talking about Mike. You said part of the reason they ended the show was because she left.
Yes.
That is not one of the reasons. Because the show survived for 3 years without her.
But that is one of the reasons. They took her off.
Oh, you think 3 years later they realized, you know what, this ain't working?
They wrote Mike off. Once they wrote Mike off, the show started going downhill. Because the show started going downhill, they had to stop the show.
Yeah. Now, the only thing I
blame... like that 70s show when what's his name left, when
Eric
left. That
would make sense because Ashton Kutcher left and Eric left.
Yeah. Yeah, but it was still on for like 2-3 seasons after that.
Yeah, but it sucked.
Two seasons.
So they had to end it, yeah.
two seasons.
You're just making my point.
No, I'm not.
Yes, I am.
Two seasons. First of all, Ashton Kutcher and Eric were main characters. She was not a main character.
She was.
She was a secondary character.
Was she the hottest character? Because that's important. That's kind of important.
And I'm not going to lie. I love everything about her character except one thing. Yo, she married down, bro. I don't care if he's a prince of whatever. She married down.
Oh, in real life?
Yeah.
Okay.
She married down. Like, I'm just saying. For example, if you look at him. What's his name?
Harry.
Prince Harry. If you look at Prince Harry married Meghan Markle, and he was playing a soccer game and broke his hand in the first play of the game. Do you think he would have played the rest of the game? I don't think so. Do you think?
He was in the English military.
Oh, that means a lot. Don't half of them just stand there?
Just stand there with a fuzzy hat, bro.
Just stand there with the hat and don't move.
That's a king's or queen's guard.
That's all he used to do?
That's not the same thing.
Yeah, they just try not to laugh. Try not to laugh.
That's all they do. He was good at standing for 10 hours a day.
That's an art of its own.
I didn't even know England had a military.
When's the fucking last war England's been in? USA been in a war fucking 24/7, bro.
Every time World War II. Yeah, we had to protect
them. A long time ago, dude.
Look, with France and England, their military is picking up the phone and calling us.
We need backup.
Yeah, like that. That's not their military. Like, you know what? Call Biden or Trump, whoever's in right now. Like, he was not in the military. He's a telemarketer. To call USA to come and help you.
Telemarketer.
Like a telemarketer, dude.
Hey,
they're fighting over here. Can you come fucking fix this?
Like, man, I don't know what's wrong with Putin, bro, but I want to talk to
him. He's a whole patrol.
Yeah, you talk to him.
He's a whole patrol.
Like, they're the reason NATO exists.
I feel like you're just saying things.
Tell me I'm not.
I feel like you're just saying things.
Like, okay, you think NATO, we created NATO to protect Ukraine?
Nope.
Like, or to protect.
What does NATO stand for?
United Nations.
National.
No, that would be a
national is. Nations.
NATO.
Against.
All right, let's see if you get it right.
Totalitarian.
Let's see if you get it right.
North American trade. No.
North Atlantic.
North Atlantic.
Oh,
treaty organization.
Treaty organization.
Okay. So.
I have one word right.
Now, you don't think that that's the reason? Who wants the treaty more than England?
I don't think NATO is. England is part of NATO.
Yeah, they have to be. Everybody's part of NATO, except China and Russia.
Yeah, except China and Russia.
Except China and Russia.
And Ukraine a few years ago.
Maybe I'm thinking incorrectly about what I think NATO is.
Yeah, it's like a partnership between mostly everybody.
Okay, here it is. Albania, Belgium, Bulgaria, Canada, Croatia.
Oh, no, if they are, then...
Yeah. Does United Kingdom count? That's them, right?
That's them.
Okay.
And how many fucking names do they have? England, Britain.
No, no Latin countries on here. Wow.
Fucking,
that's racist.
How many names does How many names does England have?
England?
How many countries?
Britain. Is Britain a country or is it
You think about the UK. How many countries are in the UK?
England, we know what England is. But what's Great Britain?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So many fucking names.
And what's United Kingdom is England, Ireland.
England, Scotland, Wales, and Northern Ireland.
And Northern Ireland, there you go. Mm.
I think Great Britain is like one side of the UK. No, I don't know.
All I'm saying, man, I don't think he would have played the whole game. That's all I'm saying.
That's fucking hilarious. Y'all see Jack Delia? He fucking fought with the fucking broken arm, basically.
Yep, Jack Della Maddalena fought with a broken arm.
And he won, dude.
Like, I'm not going to lie, I would have quit.
Yeah.
What's the point?
To win.
To win, bro.
Yeah, but I'm like, I think...
To be the ultimate fighting champion, bro. No, I applaud him because I had him on Price Picks on the under on the strikes. And good thing he broke his fucking arm because he didn't throw that last fucking strike.
Look, talking about the military, there's a gas station by my mom's house.
Okay.
I want to hear the correlation.
Listen, he got me on the edge of my seat.
There's a gas station by my mom's house. The Valero by my mom's house. You know which one I'm talking about, right?
Yeah, okay.
Where I swear, the cops they have in that Valero, I swear they pick them up from Home Depot. They cannot confuse. There's no way they don't, bro. Like, if we're going to finish early today. If y'all want, we can stop by. Yeah. Like, we can go get something to eat. We can go see them. Like, I am not kidding. This is not a joke. Like, you see them. Like, you see. I was going to say his name, but you know who I'm talking about, right? Like, you know. When you see him as a cop, he may be a good one. He may not. We don't really know. There's like seven people where he lives.
But at least he looks the part.
Yeah, but he looks the part. Yeah, at least he looks the part. Yes. When you were a cop, you should at least look the part. Like, the other day, I walk in, and there's this dude weighs 70 pounds soaking wet.
Oh, my God.
Wearing khaki pants.
Are you sure he's not a security guard?
It says police on the vest.
It does?
Yes.
Yeah.
And even then.
He's impersonating.
Yeah, oh, I'm telling you. I'm telling you.
Got that best up on Amazon.
You know what? That might be true, dude.
I am not kidding. Look, I'm saying we could go watch tonight. It's the funniest thing ever.
Bro, you can get a fucking badge on fucking Temu. motherfucker. Etsy if you want to get fancy, bro. just stick it on that motherfucker.
You're not wrong.
So I'm telling you, it's like, but you see the correlation between the military?
Absolutely not. But.
It's barely there, but it's there, dude.
Thank you. Appreciate it, David. Thank you. Shout out to David. I saw that you tagged us on that the USC was looking for podcasts.
Oh, really? Hey, but I look out for y'all, dude. I got y'all one subscriber. I got one subscriber at the wedding, bro. Or the day after the wedding. Yeah, I got y'all one, dude. Oh. Shout out Jose, dude. If you're watching this, I know you are.
Do you know who Bobby Yaloff is?
Yes.
Oh, the chick, yeah.
Do you watch her stuff at all?
No. Like whatever pops up on my
feed. Saw the last one with Andrew Santino. Exactly. He's one of my favorite comedians, so I had to.
Like
Andrew Santino, okay, I know what you're talking about. The one with the golfing?
Yeah. Redhead. He looks like the prince.
So she Bobby. Apparently she went to a birthday party. For Drake's party for some reason, and got kicked out.
Oh, she got kicked out. Holy shit!
What was the reason for it?
She wasn't invited.
That would make sense.
Would you remove her
from my birthday party?
No, because nobody would go to your birthday party. But I'm like, if you were Drake, like,
hey, somebody showed up.
Like, none of us showed up to your birthday. So he's got stupid friends. I'm gonna tell you the Louis' birthday. Can I say it now?
Sure.
Yeah. I think so. Yeah, because you already had the party, right? There's none of. Well, I don't know. Your friends are stupid, so maybe they don't know. But so, I think his name was Louis.
Yeah, his name was Louis.
Oh okay. Shit.
Guess what? I don't know him. Like, if your name was Juan, Luis, or Carlos, you would be like, oh, there's a lot of people with this name.
Yeah, right? Sure.
Right. So. If your name is that, and you're planning a party for somebody whose name is that, if your name was Luis and you're planning a party for Luis, when you send out an invitation, a text message to somebody who you don't know,
okay,
you wouldn't be like, hey, maybe he knows another Luis.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
And not only that, you wouldn't. So he sends an invitation saying, hey, we're planning a. Hey, this is Luis. We're planning a birthday party for Luis. It's a surprise. Don't tell him. Hey, guess what? I opened the message. Guess who's standing next to me?
A guy named Luis.
Another guy named Luis.
Holy shit. These motherfuckers spawn everywhere, dude.
So, he doesn't put a last name, no description, no nothing.
That's hilarious, dude.
So, now I'm supposed to randomly show up. Yeah, yeah. To a random place.
And you can't tell Lewis, and this guy's name's Lewis. You can't even RSVP, bro.
I can't RSVP. I can't talk to this guy.
Hey, yo, I'm coming, because that's Lewis.
He's lucky anybody showed up.
You're not wrong. You're not wrong.
He's lucky anybody showed up. Dude. Like, so.
I'll be at love.
I'm going to answer my own question. If that guy shows up, I'll remove him.
Stupid.
Can't have stupid people in my party. But like, would you remove, like, if you were Drake's status?
Huh.
You think there was some controversy with what?
There was some controversy about her interview with him. Because I believe it was either her or her husband's birthday. And instead of doing that or the day right after, she jetted off to go see Drake. Which I understand, it's a big interview, whatever, but like, I don't know. They made a big deal out of it. Now she's divorced. Like, I don't fucking know.
No, but I think she ended up having to take that interview down.
So, yeah, there's something happened with that, too. Yeah. So, that's all I understand.
I don't know, man. I don't know what to believe or not to believe. Because apparently, no woman can ever talk to Drake without smashing him.
Yeah, apparently that's
the, part of the contract.
It's part of it's like.
Yeah.
So, it's like. Now, it was weird. They had a podcast like on a. It was in their bed or whatever.
Yeah.
In the bed, yeah.
That was weird. But besides that, but it's like, it's a character, right? So the husband knew. So that part's different. No, there's been no, what's the word I'm looking for? Confirmation that they were involved. Nobody's ever seen them after that day.
Yeah. Nothing.
Like, there's just a whole bunch of rumors going on. Now, like, would you play the free pass game with your girl?
Say it again.
Have you ever played that, the free pass game with your girl?
Free pass. Oh,
wait, like what's the free pass game? Yeah.
Like, if you had one person on your list.
Oh. No, I don't think so.
Like, would you?
We've never played, but I've played. She doesn't get a pass, but I do. That's how we play, dude.
Who would be your free pass?
Would it be my free pass?
Ooh, let's see. There's so many options.
It's hard to choose just one.
I know. That's the problem. Yeah.
No. But honestly, I would be like... I wouldn't choose like Beyonce or Halle Berry or... Because that's like... Because if I ever have a chance, like... I'm calling it in. I'm sorry. Like, okay. I'm calling your bluff. So I would make it somebody who's famous enough where she doesn't think I can. But someone who I'm like is still not an A-list celebrity. It's still a C-list enough celebrity where she could fall enough.
Okay.
she might stick around.
Yeah, she could fall enough to get to me. You know what I mean?
Man.
So.
It's all right. So if we had to pick one, but it has to be like a C-list celebrity.
No, it could be an A-list. But I'm just saying, it's like it has to be A-list enough for your girl to accept it. But
B-list.
No, I still think it has to be A-list enough. Like, I think Bobby Adloff is a good example.
I don't think she's A-list.
But I don't think she's hot either.
I think she's trendy right now.
Okay.
Oh, you know what I mean? So that could trick people into thinking she's A-list. Where in 3 years, she could be like D-list.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
What's the thing about fame nowadays?
Exactly.
Dude? If you're hot, you're hot. You're an A-lister.
Exactly. If you're hot, you're hot right now.
It depends on how long you can keep it.
Now, I think the thing about fame is that if you are talented, if you have a talent that you can exploit, if you're funny, if you're a good actor, if you're a good singer, if you're a good drawer, if you're a good writer, whatever, that's just going to give you longevity, right? Because you could keep reinventing yourself. Mm-hmm. But if you just kind of ran across something... Mm-hmm. That you're the hot 15 minutes for now, like that's the thing you gotta go. Somebody that's so hot for this 15 minutes, like who could that be? Who would be on your list?
Was hot for a second.
Man, I can't think of anybody right now.
I know one. Oh, y'all don't watch sports. Google a girl named Taylor Rooks.
Taylor Rooks. Man, you know what? That might be a good pathway to go. An athlete, a female athlete.
American journalist? Okay.
Because female athletes don't get much, you know, fame, but
She's like the hottest thing right now. Like, in, I think, I don't know.
She's a reporter.
She's for like ESPN, and she's like.
Yeah. I think.
But look at that. That's my competition. I could win that.
Who is this?
So it's like, so if, for example, somebody who's hot right now, but we don't know. She may not be in 5 years.
Yeah.
And then the recruit's coming up.
The paths are changing, right?
And we're going down. We're on our way to Tennessee.
Oh yeah,
we're on our way to Tennessee. We're in first class.
In a limo or whatever the fuck. Yeah,
we're in the plane in first class. Oh, hey, yeah. I know you.
PJs, yeah.
Yeah, where you going? Oh, I'm in 32. 32. Oh, 32E. Yeah. Like, we're
what, in first a peasant. Class. You're a peasant at that point.
We're in first class.
Yeah.
You wanna fly the plane?
I can make it happen, baby.
You want to fly the plane? We can do
another
that.
Another pilot. What are we talking about? Yeah.
Like, I'm telling you. So that type of thing. Like, cause like, I'm pretty sure Luis was gonna say like.
I was gonna say Salma Hayek.
Salma Hayek.
Salma Hayek.
By the time Salma he makes Hayek. It, she's gonna be dead. So it's like. Salma Hayek like 73.
So, and she still looks amazing.
Yeah, she still does look amazing. But by the time he makes it, she's gonna be like 80. So it's like, that's what I'm saying. It's like Salma Hayek is just not.
Yeah.
It's your girl. You're like, she yeah, fine. The, yeah. Put her on the list. You're never gonna get her.
Okay, for me.
And then she tells you like, Bobby Lee.
What the fuck? Where did Bobby Lee come from?
Like, she man, can, she can get Bobby Lee.
If she was, yeah.
And then you'll be like, oh, fine, put him on the list. Yeah. And then you're like, oh shit. He comes to a comedy club and
he's that's all he takes.
That's it, man. Yeah. She's like, I got free tickets to a show. Yeah, which show? Like, bitch, hold up.
Mine's probably Olivia Munn.
That's Olivia too much. That's too A list, man.
You think so?
Olivia Munn is a real actress. Like a legitimate actress. Olivia Munn.
Okay, I'm trying to think lower than I just don't know that many.
I know. You know where I would go? I'd go UFC, dude. Not even a fighter, dude. Meghan Oliveri.
Oh yeah, Meghan Lee.
Yeah.
I was thinking her too.
Yeah.
No, wait, but bitch. her husband. Yeah.
Yeah. No. Yeah, no. I'll train, dude. I don't give a fuck.
I watch UFC.
And a little bit of Portuguese too, buddy. Come on.
Meghan Oliveri. That's not a bad call.
I would go there.
You know what? From UFC, Laura Sanko. Laura Sanko is perfect if you ask me, cause she could beat us up.
Yeah, dude.
She's an analyst, but she was a pro. There's another girl. If you want to Google her, her name is Katie Nolan.
Ooh, you know it's another one, another like kind of reporter, Kate Adobo, or Adobe.
You're not wrong, but I think she is A-list though.
Yeah, she's not going down.
Yeah, she's not going down. But
she's skyrocketing.
But she's so yeah, she's pretty.
I love her, dude.
Katie Nolan.
Yeah, I would. And
okay, yeah.
What was your girl?
No, Kate Abdo. But she's like A-list.
Yeah,
right,
dude. I got to compete with Thierry Henry on that one.
Yeah, she's like A-list.
Okay.
But she's fine.
Yeah, dude. She's also taken currently. So.
I can't think of anyone in particular right now that is it's A-list right now, but could fall off quickly.
Yeah, it's a tough one, man. Because like I said, if you're hot, you're hot. It's just... It's a matter of time.
Yeah, it's a matter of time when you become a B-list, C-list, 7.
Okay. I forgot what her name is, but she's a YouTuber.
She's a YouTuber.
She's a YouTuber that turned musician.
What kind
musician.
Of YouTube?
She was big in the Vine days.
Damn. You love old ladies.
You talking Amanda Cerny?
I think so.
Google, I think she was pretty hot.
Oh, that... It wasn't who I was thinking about, but yes.
Definitely her.
Put it like this.
His hand is broken, bro. Come on, dude.
But he's a thug, though.
I'm trying to think of the girls. I don't know.
Yeah, Amanda Cerny, that would be one.
She's my age. Let me DM her.
and then there's a...
She got, like, fake boobs, though. I don't like that shit.
There's another one.
You want to hear something funny? Oh, yeah. I followed her by accident.
Accident, sure.
There's another one. I'm trying to think who.
From the Vine days.
From the Vine days.
Is she like?
She's the one that I would always fall.
Curly hair?
I don't know. I think she's Venezuelan.
Hey, want to be on the Red Crew?
She looks like a white chick. She looks white, she's... you're talking about Lily Pons.
Lily Pons, yes.
Yeah, yeah. She's...
Isn't she a porn star?
No.
All right. Damn. All right.
Who did you?
it's a win-win.
Yeah.
No, I didn't say anything disrespectful.
Which one is it, Cerny?
Yeah. Hey, want to be on the Red Crew? And.
But you should have messaged her from the Red Crew channel, because then she's gonna look at me like, what is the Red Crew?
That's fine. What you call it? Something funny?
Sure, reply.
I went to the 50 Cent concert.
Oh yeah, how was that?
And my niece, we were waiting too long, and my niece got mad, went on her Instagram, and DM 50 Cent to every hello.
Holy shit!
Can you imagine? He's going back to the dressing room for one of his outfit changes. I gotta hurry up.
I got fans.
She went off on him. You know, like, hey, hurry the hell up.
How old is your niece?
12.
Yeah, they're bold.
That's
nowadays,
some awareness
dude.
for
they're bold nowadays, dude.
Yeah, she went on the DM. She's like, I got this. Yeah, cause I was complaining.
I'll get him out here, bro.
20 minutes later, done.
I was complaining, and she's like, I got it. And she went in, did her thing. Eventually, he came out.
Nice.
And I don't see another reason that it was because he. It had to be that. I don't know what else, man.
That's how the world works nowadays, buddy. DMs.
Can you imagine he shouts her out like he says, Chesco's knees, I'm out here now.
Chesco's knees, yeah. You woke me up. The fucking notification woke me up. You know what I'm saying?
Look, y'all want to hear something?
So.
That's not what I was trying to do. I don't know what the hell is going on.
Gotcha. Try your other hand, bro.
Yeah.
The truth that never beats around the bush, never walks on eggshells, that hurts your feelings sometimes, he's not the asshole. All your other friends that sit idly by while you destroy yourself and tell you that you're just fine.
Can't hear any of what you're saying.
They're the assholes. The best friends you can have in the world are the ones that don't care what you want to hear. They only tell you what you need to hear, and they'll keep it 100% real always.
I think I've heard
the
this.
Friends that you hate the most in the short term are going to be the ones that you love the most in the long term. Because they have your best interest in mind. They want to see you fulfill your potential and be what they know you can be.
Okay, so that message. I'm that guy.
I would agree.
And why do they always call me an asshole? You call me that all the time.
But I
want my apology right now in front of the entire world.
We have discussed this.
I want my apology.
Truth isn't always easy to hear.
Who cares?
You don't.
Not him.
Obviously, you don't. But we need people in our lives like that to tell us the truth, to tell us what we really need to hear, what we want to hear, to really humble us. And I agree. I've told you this before. And I think you called me out on it. That why would you take his advice but not my advice?
Absolutely.
But at that time, I wasn't ready to hear
your friends
advice.
Are idiots. I already told you.
I was talking about like, idiot.
Well, he's one of them. Hey, and again, the only reason I brought this up because I want my apology.
That's not going to happen.
See? Because he calls me a whole bunch of names that hurt my feelings to the core.
I thought you were a thug.
I am a thug, but thugs have feelings.
I didn't think they had feelings.
Thugs have feelings.
Put it on a shirt. Thugs have feelings.
Thugs have feelings. That would sell. That would sell.
That's going to be our first piece of merch. Thugs have feelings.
The Red Crew.
The Red Crew. Thugs have feelings.
Yeah, I want 20%, bro. Fuck that.
No, I think I deserve my credit. Don't y'all think?
No. That's true.
I'm not the hero you want.
I'm the hero you need. Okay? And then we should have this conversation. Like, should you approach your girl this way? Or should you?
I think that's a better conversation to have.
Let's have it. Yeah, that's true.
Should you approach your girl
with that same attitude?
I think so.
Well, I think it's both ways. So, like he's saying, like, you know, your friends that walk on eggshells, right? Mm-hmm. Versus the opposite, like, to tell you how it is. For girls, you gotta be right in the fucking middle, you know? You can't fucking make them cry because then your words go out the door, you know?
I don't think so. I think you should be as brutally honest with your partner as you should be with your friends. Now, Delivery is everything.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Delivery, you gotta walk on some eggshells.
How you deliver it makes the biggest difference.
It has to do with it, though.
I've said it here on the podcast.
Because that's what I'm saying. Like, the second she starts crying, she don't want to hear nothing you got to say. And then whatever you say, truthful or not, it's out the window. It doesn't matter at that point.
I've said it here on the podcast. If my girl asks me a question, I'm going to answer honestly. If I'm not giving you the question, the answer that you wanted, you shouldn't have asked the question in the first place. If you ask me, do I look good in this dress, and I don't think you look good in that dress, I'm going to tell you you don't look good
in this
dress.
Okay, Luis, you can't have it both ways.
Yeah. What is both ways?
You came here, it's like, my girl is the prettiest woman I've ever seen in the history of life.
And we've
determined
that beauty is in the eye of the beholder.
Okay, so what the hell happened to your eyes when she asked you about the dress?
I don't think she looks good in that
like,
dress.
Like, she can't be the most beautiful woman on earth and then look bad in the dress. She's still beautiful, right?
She herself is beautiful, but she doesn't look great in that dress.
No,
that doesn't take away from her beauty.
That's a stupid fight to have. Yeah. A stupid fight to have. There's nobody.
You call it a fight? I call it being helpful.
Is not being helpful.
If she asks me, do I look fat in this? I'm going to tell, if you look fat, I'm going to tell you look fat. Because I would rather you get mad at me because I'm telling you look fat. You go out and somebody says, congratulations.
You look fat?
No, congratulations. Why? For what?
For the baby.
You're due soon, right? I would rather me be the asshole than somebody be the asshole and you really get your feelings.
Nah, I'd rather them be the asshole. Fuck that shit, bro. Why? I don't got to deal with that shit.
Can you answer that? Why would you rather be the asshole than a random stranger be the asshole?
Because I'm going to ruin the next 20 minutes. That's going to ruin her whole night, if not her whole weekend.
Why?
Because now she's going to feel self-conscious. Because now she's got to stay with that decision.
Wait a minute.
Now, she's got to stay with the decision of wearing the dress or the outfit.
You're a moron.
Look fat.
You're a moron. You think she's going to take more. She's going to be hurt more by a random person's opinion than by yours?
Yes, because because when she's asking me, she knows that I'm looking at her through rose-colored lenses.
Okay.
The other person is impartial. They could care less. And if they're saying something meaning it well but coming off bad, it's even worse.
No, but you have the power at that point to say, you know, that person's stupid, right?
But at that point, what you say, because and it could be true, that person is stupid.
It is. Yeah,
what you say at that point doesn't matter.
Oh no, it always matters. That's where you're wrong. Yeah. it always matters. That's why I'm saying you have to pick random fights. You have to. Now, what I'm not going to do, my girl knows not to ask me dumbass questions. She knows not to ask me dumbass questions. Do I look pretty in this dress? Of course you do.
Yeah.
Okay? Anything. Am I the great best cook in the world? Yes, you are. Adam, what's his name? Or Gordon, what's his name?
Gordon Ramsay.
Gordon Ramsay has nothing on you. And to be honest, my girl can't even cook. But if she asks me, you're the best in the world.
If she ever asks me, I'll tell her honestly.
Like the other day we were watching, I don't know why, but we were watching women's soccer. She's like, do you think I could do that? I was like, absolutely. I kind of meant that one a little bit. But, but I was like, yeah, you can.
That, yes.
Yeah. I'm like, and then guess what? She was happy as all could be.
Yeah.
I get the
logic. You can definitely make a bad pass.
I get the logic behind it. And what did Devin say?
Like, you can definitely make a bad pass. Yeah. You can definitely go out there and jog around. Yeah. There's things that are subjective, right?
Yeah.
So if she's asking your opinion, just lean your opinion towards her.
Yeah, like, that's what I was saying.
Because it's not a fact.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's things that don't matter. Do I look good in this dress? You're no freaking expert on dresses. Just say yeah.
There's
and also I think your opinion, if like, let's say the dress thing, if you tell her, if let's say you're lying, but if you tell her before somebody else gets to her and you say, yeah, you look good in that dress, whenever this other fucknut comes and says, oh, are you fucking pregnant? She's like, what the fuck is up with this guy? She'll be on your side. I think she'll feel better. It's a win-win for you and her. You know, she'll disregard this person a little more than you know, having to say that. Question? Yeah.
If your girl comes and asks you, do I look fat in this dress? and you genuinely think she doesn't. Yes. And you say, no, no, you don't. And then you go out and the guy still...
Oh, she doesn't. Okay, go ahead. Sorry.
You genuinely think she doesn't. And then a random stranger comes and says, congratulations. The fuck you do then?
at least I can die. I can die saying I was truthful to myself.
It's stupid. It makes no difference. It makes no difference. One day you're going to have one... Well, actually, you did nothing. She's going to feel bad one time from a random stranger. That other day, she's going to feel bad twice.
Twice, bro.
One because of you, bro. And one because of the stranger. So it's like, it means nothing. What do you do that day?
Thankfully, I don't think I've...
Oh, yeah.
This will never happen.
I have been in conversations where she asked me if I look good in this. And I've told her, well, I don't think this really matches, or I don't think this looks great on with what you have going on.
And did she change?
Yes.
See?
And you just hurt yourself. That proves my point, though. She cares about your opinion a little more.
That hurts. That just hurts too.
What's more common?
Now, what if you're going to a function and you're late and you don't got time for her to change and you want to be on time? Would you still tell her no?
Look, I'm not going to tell her unless she solicits.
That's an extra 30 minutes, my boy, for her to find some other
shit. If she asks me, I'm going to tell her. If she doesn't ask me, I'm not going to say anything. But if she asks me, I'm going to be honest with her 100% of the time.
Okay, dude.
I'm 100% opposite. I'm not even gonna look at it.
Yep.
I'm like, you look great.
What's more? You'd be like, yep, you look great.
No, and this helps me everywhere because when we're at the mall, she's like, should I buy this? I'm like, yeah. Like I want to wear this. It could literally be like a towel. And I buy it. I could give a fuck. Like, you think this looks good? I'm like, it looks amazing. Because the truth is that I don't know about women's dressing.
Yeah, that's true.
So it's like, say, hey, what are you asking me for?
No, but I
you know how many times I look at her like, should I buy this shirt?
She says, hell no.
Never! I've never been like, should I buy this shirt?
Okay.
You know who? I buy the shirt.
Right.
That's it. It's like, we don't need each other for everything.
No,
it's me teaching her independence.
This is not an everyday situation.
If I go blind one day, what's she gonna do? Like Luis one time said, okay, David, if your girl comes and asks you, are you the best I ever had?
Duh. Duh.
What would you say?
Now that's a silly question.
I think I was early in the relationship at that point. See? You know?
He was like, oh, like, no, I would be honest. I'm like, shut up.
I think if I'm early in the relationship, I say the truth. If I'm not early in the relationship, the truth is.
Then what the hell changes? What the hell changes?
That I need to make sure. If I don't like the things you're doing, then I gotta let you know. And like you said, you shouldn't be asking stupid questions.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
But
that is a stupid question in the first place.
But you just gonna make things worse by giving a stupid answer.
Yeah.
You don't give a stupid answer to a stupid question.
Don't ask it if you don't want to know.
Like, well, that's how we're different, male and female. Sometimes a girl just wants like reassurance,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's just reassurance.
And for you to say
you're not gonna get it from me.
Fuck, dude.
No.
Hey, you're up there.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Those questions to us are stupid. Because we know the answer she wants to hear, you know? And it's like, we know the answer, period. But, you know, sometimes
questions
you just gotta be like...
I'm not gonna lie. At the rodeo, questions are just hard.
At the rodeo?
What happened at the rodeo?
At the rodeo, we were leaving the concert. We were leaving the rodeo. And we were trying to find our way back to the car. And this dude comes up to me asking me, like, SAT questions. He's like, where y'all going? Like, bro, I don't know, man.
I don't even know where
like,
I am.
I don't know. I'm like, and I got mad at him. He's like, where y'all going? Hey, like, man, why are you asking so many questions? Like, I don't know. Like, this the whole SAT, this test I got to take right now. I don't know.
Is there any other questions, or is that the only one?
That was the only one. Okay. But you don't know what was coming next.
Yeah.
So I had to nip it in the bud. I'm like, bro, I don't know, homie. Like, where you going?
I don't know. Where the fuck you going, man? Shit.
Like.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, well, man.
I thought it was one of those guys that, you know, like, if you go to Sixth Street or fucking Washington, they're like, they got a mic and they're like, hey, if your girl asks you, do I look fat in this dress? You know, like those fuckers. I thought it was that.
Yeah.
No.
It's probably an Uber driver.
No, the security guy. The fuck?
I don't think it was a security guy. What would they care?
Yeah.
I have no idea. That's why I got confused. I saw him. He's like, where are you going?
I don't know. Where are you going?
Literally, when he asked me, where are you going? I felt like he's like, how do you build a spaceship? I'm like, I don't know.
Hey, after a long night at the rodeo, I'm
like,
bro,
I don't know, man. Like,
you ain't trying to use your brain no more, bro.
Like, I've never been so confused in my life.
Who are you again?
Like, dude, I just 50 Cent just performed 21 questions. I ain't got no room for more, bro. Yeah, bro. He already asked 21 questions.
That's
I don't
my limit,
more.
Bro. 21,
yeah,
bro.
21 was my limit, bro. Yeah, that was it for me, dude. I didn't know what to say. So that's why. And honestly, I turned to my girl. She's like, see, this is why you don't ask stupid questions. I don't know, man. I think I have the key to a perfect relationship.
Don't ask stupid questions.
No. Every time they ask you a stupid question, you just answer it. Like anything. It can be anything. Can I cook? Yes. Can I sew? Yeah. Can I paint? Paint the whole house if you want.
Yeah.
Like, go ahead. Do whatever you want. Paint it with nail polish. Like, do whatever you want.
I think that might even look better now.
Yeah. I'm like, yeah. Like, do whatever you want. It's like, now, just don't ask. Like, if you want to get cursed out, then ask me if you can go on a 20-day girls trip or things like that. But like. But like, can you cook? Yeah, of course you could cook. Like, and the best thing is when she asks you, can I cook? Then she cooks and y'all go out to eat. Like,
yeah.
She's self-aware enough to know that.
Yeah, she's like, hey, can I cook? I'm like, yeah, go cook. Then we'll go to Wingstop when you're done. Like, things like that. Like, that's how you answer things. He's like, do I look good in this dress? I'm like, yeah. All right, let's go. Now put this hoodie on.
Like, yeah.
That's how you answer things. Like,
Just going with the flow and making it keep flowing.
No, but
flowing,
I like,
you know?
I like my girl. We go to Victoria's Secret. Like, the secret to that is she goes to Victoria's Secret, I go to Foot Locker.
Yeah.
I've never spent more than 2 minutes in Victoria's Secret.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And I see guys in there. She's like, yeah, you should get this one. I'm like, shut up, bro. Why are you acting like you care?
Yeah. Why you care?
Why would you care?
Yeah. I care.
Why would you care?
Why?
Yeah.
Because that's what she's going to be wearing whenever she's around me.
I don't want her to wear it. I want her to take it off. I could care less if she's wearing it. Like what the hell?
Red, blue, purple, take it off.
It sets the mood.
I've never seen a guy. And I do agree with this. Like a girl does have to take care of her, like her nails and things like that. Like, I agree with that. Yeah. You know, paint your nails, whatever color. Like, but let's say you paint them blue, pink, green, yellow. It ain't gonna make a damn difference to me. As long as they're not all nasty and dirty.
Chips just and shit.
They could be clear. I don't care as long as just they're not dirty.
You don't have a preference on lingerie though? You could care less.
I could care less.
No, okay, I do.
It's a plus, but I mean,
no, I could care.
It's not a minus without it though, you know?
There's not.
No, I agree with that. Yeah. That's a great way of putting it.
Yeah.
That's a great way of putting it.
To me,
special like, occasions.
Yeah, she wears it, but it's not like, oh, if she wouldn't wear it, I'm like, oh, I missed it.
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck? So no, it's nothing. I don't care about it. It's like, what I'm saying is like, what I mean that I don't care about it is like, there's no way that I've ever see a guy like she wearing by lingerie, and your answer is like, ah, you should have got the other one.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Like, that never happened. Like,
I don't know. That's this true. Guy, bro.
So what do you
mean? No. I agree.
Like, no, there's no preference.
Get both.
So that's why she asked me which one you prefer. I'm like, I can care less. It's coming off anyway.
Hopefully, at least.
Like, which one would I rather see on the floor?
Yeah, that's where it's gonna end up.
So same thing with like nail polish. It's like, should I get blue, green? I'm like, I could care less. Throw a dart at the rainbow and pick it. It would be like, you know what, I don't want to anymore because I preferred it for it to be blue
and you pick green.
Yeah, and you pick green. Like, no, that just doesn't happen.
Like my girl, one thing she asks a lot is, which perfume do you want me to wear? And she thinks I remember which. She's like fucking 20 of them. She's like, this one, this one, this one. And then I it's random, but I, this one. And she's like, what? I thought you liked this one. I was like, yeah, I do. But, you know, just for today, you know, get this one. I don't know what none of the fucking shit smell like, dude. I swear.
It's no different than with girls with us in like shoes.
Yeah.
Like, I think they do want us to, you know, fix up and dress and look presentable. Now, if you were 13, she wouldn't be like, oh, I want you to wear the 11s. Gonna matter.
Yeah.
As long as you look presentable.
Yeah.
It's same thing with, like, so no, I'm not going to Victoria's Secret. I'm like, pick one. And the quicker the better. The cheaper the better too.
I was gonna say, yeah.
Yeah, the quicker the better. Like, I had a friend who we used to go to the mall and he would window shop. Like, that's something I can't do.
Yeah, no.
I can't do that.
I can't do that.
If I go anywhere,
it's gotta be in and out.
It's because I know what I'm gonna get.
Yeah, exactly. Dude, I haven't been to the mall to buy something in ages, bro. I had to go buy a suit for this wedding. I went in, I didn't like it. Fuck, I'm aware what I got at the crib, bro. I was like, man, this is insane, dude. It's online shopping for me, dude.
I window shop there. Like, I'll scroll through, like, Amazon. I'll see, okay, this looks cool.
Yeah. Oh, just add it to the cart and never buy it? Just add it to the cart.
I'll either add it to the cart or I'll add it to my favorites.
I stopped doing that because I used to lay in bed and go through Amazon.
And that's a problem.
And spend thousands of dollars and not need half of the things.
Yeah. Like I told you, I just got into like making cocktails, right?
Nice.
I bought like 30 different versions of like bitters and cocktail juices and stuff like that.
And Luis don't even drink.
I used two. Yeah.
And Luis don't even drink. Luis drink like a cup a night.
Two drinks, two old fashioned.
Two drinks the entire night. Like what in Utah, we bought two bottles.
What happened to him?
Well, me and E.T. finished ours.
Holy shit.
And it was a Bucana bottle. Which one did you get?
It was a Jameson
bottle. Did you buy the Bucana?
No, I bought the...
He bought something.
It was the tequila.
You know how it's like... It's the bottle is thin.
Yeah.
And then fat.
Mm-hmm.
It got to like a quarter of the fat part. It was the whole night, literally. It wasn't like... Yeah. I'm not talking from 8 to 2.
Yeah.
It was from 9 to 9.
It was
him and Ray.
No, him. Ray wasn't drinking tequila. It was just
Ray poured one drink and that thing got like halfway.
What the fuck?
So I'm like,
it's vacation, boys. Come on.
No, if you were with David, that would be crazy.
Yeah, dude. I would have been like, what's
David's excessive? Look. Yeah. David's excessive. Yeah, David's excessive.
On vacation.
Only on vacation.
On vacation, yeah. You gotta enjoy your time off, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Is that why you don't go anywhere with us no more? Or is it because you're whipped? Which one is it?
What is the reason? What is the question?
Because we make you drink too much? We didn't make you drink anything.
First of all, you don't make me drink.
Yeah, we didn't make him drink.
Yeah.
So why don't you want to hang out with us no more? Let's talk about this on the podcast because it's a very serious situation.
How many guy ships have we taken at least?
No, we've planned three.
How many have we taken?
One.
Miami and Utah.
No, that you haven't gone to?
No.
In total?
Two, right?
No. We've already gone on four.
Miami? No, that I've been included.
You've been included. You chose not to go to.
I've gone two.
Well, three. No, two.
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 Utah and Miami.
And we've gone to four. And you chose not to be in two. No, you choose.
Cancun and
Colombia. And Colombia.
Colombia.
And then you chose not to go to the one we're going to.
Look.
And you chose not to go to Colombia.
In all honesty, I think it's... I don't know if it's the opposite of FOMO, right? It's
the fear of being there?
No, definitely not that.
Hey, bro. I'm going to have to check Grey's Anatomy for that one, bro. I've never seen that one, buddy.
What the hell?
It's called anxiety, bro.
I'm very selective with my money.
We're not going to have this conversation.
Oh, shit.
We're not. Luis, what are you doing with? Are you going to buy the house cash?
I'm trying to.
Why, though? It's like, not good to buy a house.
Yeah. Like, why?
Because interest rates right now are freaking through the roof.
Yeah, but that's just what it is, dude.
Mindsets like that that get you into debt.
Everybody in the world buys their. I have them. Yeah. I'm right now. I got a mortgage. I own property now. I don't know if I'm proud of that or not.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, it got finalized a couple weeks ago.
Congratulations.
Yeah, nice.
Don't congratulate me. I don't like it. Because I don't live in it.
Okay, then why would you buy it?
To rent it out.
Okay.
And and now I'm a landlord. I did not work this hard to be a landlord.
Yeah, to get another job.
We're going to have to fix this. I'm sorry. Okay, finish your story and I'll finish mine. Your fear of being there.
Oh, no, I'm just very selective with my money.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. Yeah, going back to everybody in the world has a mortgage.
I'm afraid that I'm going to go and not enjoy my time.
What?
I'm afraid that I'm going to plan something and go out with you guys and not enjoy my time.
Just drink a little more, buddy.
maybe that's what it is.
That's cheap, bro.
I'm not going to say how much he makes, but I can say you make more than $50K, right?
Absolutely.
He makes more than $50K? We're like a $300 a month overhead.
The way that you plan trips is perfect because of the fact that you have one activity that at least you know you're going to enjoy.
Yeah.
I've come around a little bit more to that. It's the flight that does it for me.
What do you mean?
The flights. The flights are usually very expensive.
Like $300.
No, Colombia was not $300.
You didn't go.
Because of how expensive it was going to be.
No, you told us because it was a weekday trip.
That too.
Yeah, there's another
one. He just makes up shit. He just makes up shit. That's what I'm saying. No, Luis, it has something weird. I don't know what it is. Because, Luis, you net more than us. We've already established this. You net more than us.
Yes, but a lot of that goes to my savings.
ET has a mortgage. I have businesses. And
lot of that goes to my savings because I'm trying to buy a house.
That's what I'm saying. ET has a mortgage right now as we speak. Now I have a lesser mortgage. Plus I have businesses that I have mortgages on. So what I mean, like, it's enough is what I'm saying. Nobody's saying go out there and spend $30,000 on a trip. We're saying our trips never go beyond $3K ever. And if it doesn't even get close.
3K? No, fuck no.
It doesn't get close to 3K. If maybe it scratches 2. Maybe.
Part of the reason, and I'm going to be completely honest right now, that it scares me going out with you guys is because I've heard of how much you guys spent on the Cancun trip on one night. And I'm like, fuck. I would feel bad if I didn't pitch it.
No, but you're saying like it was $2,000.
It was a lot of money.
It was, it was around $2,000.
Okay.
But so,
you're saying like it's
$3,000.
Yeah.
And that's still like.
That's $700.
For drinks? Nah.
But no, it's for the night, not for drinks. Yeah, it's $700. Well, no, the entire trip, we spent $700 cash each on the Cancun trip. Like, because, and we also know what we're doing. If we know we're only going to go out one night, and we have this amount of money. Like, fuck it. It's money to blow.
Right? It's in the budget.
It's in the budget. Yeah, like, we have a budget. Yeah. What he is he's reckless and he doesn't listen. Like, he almost sold his car in Miami. Because we came from the... Oh, you went. Oh, so, okay. Yeah. How much did you spend in Miami, the club?
Oh, yeah. I don't even think it hit 2K. It was less.
Okay.
Yeah.
2K.
Yeah.
Let's say 2K. He was thinking, he was having trouble paying $30 to collect. So, no, he was.
No. Gotta put it into context.
For
the entrance fee at 1:30.
Yeah.
30 minutes before close.
That's what I mean. It's just the math.
And it wasn't 30. It was like 50 bucks.
Okay. 50 bucks. But what I'm saying, he was nowhere near 2K. So, that's what I'm saying. So, what But the reason we were gonna have to pay that was because, I don't know, he just decided, he didn't tell us anything. He's like, we're going to Miami.
The club,
Miami. We're going to Miami. And what did we say? Said, all right.
Yeah, okay.
All right, yeah. You told the wrong guys, buddy.
Me looking at the club, I was like, Luis is going to learn his lesson today. I didn't say a word.
It's a badass
club. I didn't even look it up. As soon as I was like,
good thing that they let us in.
And that's what Edgar was so quiet. Tell me I'm not wrong.
Why?
Tell me I'm wrong. And he's like dancing all oblivious. I'm like, yo, what's the punch that's coming, man? I'm just waiting. Luckily, they didn't let us in.
Oh, shit.
Because the way we were dressed.
Yeah. There's that.
Because he didn't tell us where we were going.
Yeah.
But we didn't prepare for that. Yeah. So, and as soon as, because it was, as soon as, I was like, yeah, Luis doesn't know what he's getting himself into right now.
You guys messed out, bro.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, man. But me talking about money, like, I've noticed that I care less about money every day. I do. Maybe it's because I get a little bit more of it, but I care less about money every day because this landlord thing is not going to work. We're going to have to work something out because this is just not going to work.
There should be companies that would
do the services for
you. Yeah, maybe, we're going to have to work something out because I've noticed now at this point, I'm not going to do anything for money that I don't want to do. Like, I get it. Real estate is a great business. It is. And I guess maybe... what would you give the percentage that you could get rich off of real estate? Like 10-15%? Like,
get rich of it? I mean, most how many people have been in real estate?
Yeah. No, I need it, but they're doing like huge.
But they start out small.
Yeah. Okay, but okay. Maybe it's possible. What I'm saying is, I don't want to do that. Like, I don't enjoy real estate. Like, I think for you to start with real estate, maybe I'm wrong and I understand. You got to buy a house, fix it up, flip it. Like, that's how you start off, right?
One way.
Yeah. That's a good model, yeah. Yeah, but
or what's another way?
Just buying multiples, tenants. Yeah.
Buying a multifamily home and then renting.
Okay, through that. See, and that's being a landlord. I don't want to do any of that. It's just not for me. It's not for me. I'm sorry. I don't want to talk to people, and I don't want to go and start constructing and knocking down walls and painting. And I don't want to do that. I'm not saying it doesn't work. It absolutely works.
You like passive.
Huh?
Like passive.
No, I like things that I enjoy. Like, if I can have fun. Like, that's why I'm doing the podcast. If we can make money off this podcast.
Yeah. All day.
I'll do this every freaking day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But me, wake up 8 in the morning, go work for 6 months straight to make what? $300? $400? I'm sorry, $300,000 at best?
Yeah.
So it's not a good return for me, man. I'm sorry. I just and that's all I'm saying. For example, somebody like, what business could we start here as a rec that you think we would enjoy?
I don't know. See, like, you have the benefit of knowing what you like. I don't think there's anything in particular that I'm like passionate about like you have.
Oh, but you gotta like something.
Puzzles.
What?
Puzzles.
Muscles?
Puzzles.
Puzzles. Fuck me.
That takes me back to your girl. Of answering honestly. There's no way you believe your girl likes puzzles.
Oh, I know she does.
She does it for you.
I know she does.
Like, there's nobody.
She does or she doesn't?
No, she doesn't.
What?
You think she does or she doesn't?
I know she does.
No, she does. She does.
I know she loves puzzles.
You know she doesn't.
This goes back to those questions like, hey, you want to do a puzzle?
Sure, baby. Sure, yeah.
You're the one that brings up the puzzle situation. It's not me.
Oh, shit.
Okay, I know she does.
I refuse to believe
it. I know she does.
It's hard to believe.
Like, he tells me that she thinks that he's funny.
Oh.
See?
Oh, and I know she does.
Look at his reaction.
I know she does.
No, she doesn't. But... if that's you asking, babe, do I look fat in this?
Yeah,
and she knows the right answer.
I don't have to ask if she's willfully telling me.
Yeah, it's like, again, like, there's some things that it's like, we know what to say. Like, she walks out of the bedroom, she said, you look beautiful in it, and my eyes can be closed. Like, it's that's what I'm saying. Like, Luis, you're funny, and she just has to laugh.
Look, I tell her something. I know you're lying.
You know, no, you really ain't funny.
Oh, I know I am.
Okay.
No, I know I'm not.
So that's what I'm saying. So you're saying you think your girl's stupid?
No, I just know that she's in love.
Like, that's, you think your girl's stupid? No, she's not. She's not.
No, she's in love. That's,
she's not dumb. She knows you're not funny, but she knows I have to say he's funny. It's part of the contract. Yeah. It's like, look, it's what we do here. It's like, yeah.
It's the same thing. It's going with the flow and keeping the flow going, you know?
My girl one time asked me, you think I could be like a... how do you say ama de casa? She said it in Spanish. Take care of the house.
Yeah.
Like a housewife?
Trophy wife. I don't think that's the right way, but whatever. Like saying just
stay at home wife.
Stay at home. Yeah, like clean. You know, cook, wash, just, all that.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what you think my answer was?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You think she can?
No freaking way in hell.
You said she don't know how to cook.
No way in hell she can't cook.
That's step number one, bro.
She can't. Neither one of us really know how to clean.
Yeah.
Most of the time, we try to wash the clothes, they just come out dirty and wet. Like, so it's like, we suck at folding the clothes.
Yeah.
To this day, my mom comes and help.
No way. Like, you got lucky, bro. So
how's she going to do all that? But what did I say? Of course you can. Like, you know damn well you never met nobody in life that likes puzzles and Rubik's cubes with you.
I found the one for me.
And yeah, yes you did. And trust me, the last one and the next one will also love puzzles and Rubik's cubes. Because they like have you to.
Enough. Yeah.
Yes. My girl sits there and watches soccer games with me. You think she likes soccer?
There's a difference though.
No, there's no difference. You know what she says when I ask her, do you like soccer? Yeah. Says yes, I like soccer. Does she really like soccer? Yeah, no, she doesn't like soccer.
No.
Does your girl like soccer?
I don't agree with you. Does she sit there sometimes? I don't.
She sits there. Yeah.
She sits there.
She's on her phone, but she sits there.
Exactly. Like, do I watch reality TV? Do I like reality? I hate reality TV with a passion. Do I sit there? Absolutely, I sit there.
Love is blind. I saw that whole shit, dude.
That shit was wild.
I saw the whole shit, dude.
That was wild, man.
I haven't seen the reunion, but yeah.
You haven't seen the reunion?
I was there. No, I haven't seen it.
Okay. What is Love is Blind?
It's pretty crazy.
Love is Blind is a show where they take random people and they put them in pods and have them speak to each other without seeing each other. Then they have to propose to each other. While they're still in the pod,
behind the wall, behind the wall.
For marriage.
Yeah.
Behind the wall without seeing each other. And then they go into the real world and have them go and live for like
a month. They live like 2 weeks.
And then at the end of the month,
shit,
they have to get on the altar and they have to say either I do or no.
Fucking nuts, bro.
Ah, crazy.
Yeah.
That is stupid.
It's wild because there's people that say no, right?
Yeah.
There's no shit.
But there's people that say yes too.
It's still, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. There's people that say yes. There's people that don't get to the altar. The big,
oh, that would be me.
Yeah. The big contention with this one is that there was one girl.
There's a lot of shit, bro.
Yeah.
This was
there's a lot of things. But like the main thing that I remember is that this one girl, of course, they're in the pods and she's like, yeah, who what celebrity do you look like? Because he's like, she's like,
oh, yeah.
And she's like, yeah, I've been compared to, I don't know, MGK's wife? I don't know her name. Do you know who MGK's wife is?
Megan Fox.
Megan Fox?
Yeah.
She looks nothing like Megan Fox.
Hell no, dude.
But of course, now this guy has Megan Fox in his mind.
And
he's
and
like,
honestly,
he's like, on the spot, you want
to
marry me?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He picked the wrong one. He was talking to another chick way hotter.
Oh!
And then he picked Megan Fox, who looks like fucking Jay
that
Leno.
That sucks for the girls. I mean, for the guys, right?
Both.
No, but for the girls, like, you can... Okay, we've talked about it. Like, girls... We always see it walking around town where you're like, how did he get her?
Yeah.
Oh, and,
yeah,
and it happens. And it happens.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And like, surprisingly, those are the ones that work.
No, but they didn't go to the show, is what I'm saying. This happens in real life.
No. The ones that did get married, you see the girl, you see the guy, I'm like, that guy and that girl should not be together.
Yeah. But what I'm saying is that it happens all the time.
Oh, yeah.
That's my relationship.
Yeah.
So it's like, what I'm saying is like, it happens all the time. So it's like, that sucks more for the guy. Cause
like, oh, yeah,
girls would girls get guys that are below them all the time.
Yeah.
Like, guys normally don't.
Well, they try not to.
They
right?
try not to.
They try to stay within their,
No.
We're above. We shoot for the stars, buddy.
I'm not gonna lie. Yeah. I wish that Luis was single. I really
would. Hey, you'd be great on that show, dude.
No, Luis, I'm sorry, but if I ever get single, I'm gonna have to meet your girl, and like, we're gonna have to come up with a game plan where you're like, you have to let him come out with me.
Let my girl go out with you?
No, you. Yeah. Let her. I'm gonna talk to her and let him come out with me. Why? Because I think Luis is a good looking dude.
Appreciate you.
And then he could like bring the girls over. But when it's time to talk.
That's so true.
But when it's time to talk, that's when I take over.
I bring them over. Yeah. I'm the quiet type. Exactly. You know? Yeah.
I'm like.
He's the guy in the club with the bottle.
If he talks to him, they're gone.
You know what I mean?
Bro. He's mute.
Yeah. I'm like, nah, I got you. I'll translate.
You told me I look fat in this dress. Fuck that guy.
So that's what I'm saying. If I ever turn single, I'm like, I'll go out with Luis. I'm like, Luis, go get those three girls, and then I'll handle the rest.
Bro. I'll be your wingman.
It's teamwork,
dude.
It's teamwork. For example, he could get him here, but then he couldn't convince him to do anything.
Yeah, yeah.
But I can't get him here. But I can convince him, like, you know what I mean? Yeah. So it's like... Like I got the gab, he's got the looks. Like if we could put it together, it would be great.
One superhuman, bro.
You know what I mean?
That'd be amazing.
Yeah, that would be amazing. But we can't. So we gotta work it how we can. You know what I mean?
We determined that I can't get funny.
He can't get funny.
Tried it.
There's just one woman in the world that lies to him, and he believes it.
I sure do.
So that
if she really doesn't. Then she's a great actress. She deserves an Oscar.
Yeah, dude.
See, again, another line. My girl asked me that one time, too. What? She asked me stupid shit all the time. Like, can I be an actress?
Sounds fun, dude. Yeah,
of course you can.
Yeah.
Of course you can. If I had an Oscar, I would give it to you right now.
Yeah.
Like, and guess what? She's happy for those 30 seconds.
Yeah. That's all it takes. Yeah.
I don't come up with, like, I've seen better actresses than you, but I still know. Yeah. Why? Like, if your girl asked you, am I a good actress, what would you say?
You're acting like a fool right now asking that question.
See? All right. Thank you for watching. Yeah. Please like, comment, subscribe. We killed it this week. Mm-hmm. Thank you. I want to read some of the comments. Damn. They went off on... No, we're going to save it for next week because they went off on E.T. and Ray and none of them are here.
Yeah. No way.
Yeah. I responded to some guy and he never, like, he was like, banned podcast equipment. Because we're talking about if allowing to see. And why, I don't know why he got mad. Because we're like, we're just asking, would you have problems if your girl wears revealing clothes? Like, would you be having problems?
Oh, yeah, that was close. Oh, yeah.
Would you have a problem with other people seeing your girl naked? And he responded with banned podcast equipment. And I just said, why are you mad? Did we see your girl naked? And then he never responded. Hope you subscribe though.
Yeah, yeah.
There's one that I read it today, but we definitely need to read it to, next week. Okay, the comment says, "Dude took it to a whole other level. Being seen and showing all of everything you have are not even remotely close. This dude is highly insecure if he takes being seen and takes it to that extreme. Probably a dangerous guy when he feels like you've wronged him giving the observation."
Like he knows him.
Yeah.
It's like he's part of the rec crew.
Wow, dude.
He knows him.
I hope you subscribe.
He's part of the crew, this guy.
Please like, comment, subscribe. See you next time.
Peace.